If you've spent any time on Twitter, you may know that the Sims 4 community is very vocal lately. In fact, ever since Sim Guru Frost tweeted that kits would stretch into December, many simmers have declared that The Sims 4 is ending, others are insisting that it's the worst year ever for Sims 4. This is a huge turnaround after generally positive reception for a Paranormal Stuff Pack, initial enthusiasm for Cottage Living Expansion Pack, and mixed but mostly positive reviews from base game updates such as likes and dislikes, kids being able to cook, pawn tools, and new base game swatches. So today, we're going to back up and I will show you some honest opinions from the Sims 4 community about this situation of potentially not getting an expansion pack, and give you, of course, my honest opinion, even if it's unpopular, about Sims 4 in 2021 so far. Before we go ahead and get into this mess, my name is Simra Aaron. I cover Sims 4 news, speculation, and info videos, as well as Paralives. Now, I don't think I really need a question for you today, so I just simply ask for you to share your thoughts in the comments below and try not to attack each other at least as badly as the Twitter community currently is. So in my last video, I reported, as of course a lot of people did, about a tweet from SimGuru Frost that has stirred up, let's say, a lot of emotions. Now, he did not confirm or deny a new pack coming out outside of the kit's roadmap, but many have interpreted this to mean that not only will we get kits for the rest of the year, but we're not going to be getting anything else besides some base game updates. And while I don't necessarily agree with that interpretation, I do think that even if they skipped a pack for the end of the year, there are pros and cons to that. But most of the reactions I've seen on Twitter are pretty much solidly on one side or another. So we're going to take a look at why some simmers are angry, why some are actually hopeful, and why some are just plain old skeptical. Sims 4 in 2021, Expansion Packs 1, Game Packs 1, Stuff Packs 1, and Kits 9. So clearly when we look at that, it is going to generate some emotional reaction for some people, especially people that don't like kits. Now, I've expressed my opinion many times on this channel that I do not think that kits are worth the price. And in fact, I reacted pretty terribly when kits were first announced. I think I even called them tacky. So I'm not really a kits advocate. But I do think there's a little bit more nuance here. I do think that we're getting a ton of kits, and I don't like that. But I do think there are some other sides to this. Now, he actually did go ahead and say some other sides to this as well. There was more nuance to this tweet. I don't exclude a surprise pack announcement, but still. So saying that, you know, it is still possible we might get a pack. Simmers, thank you so much for your comments and opinions. Just want to clear something. This tweet is not to show how much content we got this year, but paid packs. I made it in a funny way when I realized how many kits we got compared to other packs. So this person doesn't seem like they're actually very angry about it. They're just trying to say it in a funny way, and they did get quite a bit of reactions. So I'm not going to include reactions that simply state that Sims 4 is trash, or Sims 4 is the worst game in the world, or it's ending right now, because frankly, you all know about all those reactions. There's not really any details to those reactions. So instead, I'm going to take a look at criticism that has some supporting details, because I think that's a lot more helpful and honestly a lot more interesting. This has been the most boring year for The Sims. Maybe you all get mad, but Spa Day was a bad pack, so I don't care about it. Cottage Living is boring. Very childish gameplay. No realism. Shallow. Dream Home Decorator, terrible. Bust the Dust is my favorite. It added realism, which actually that was really an interesting take because I think that's probably not a popular opinion. I'm not going to go into opinions about each pack here. I think you can make an argument for all the packs as to them being shallow. You could also make an argument that some of the packs have some great features as well. And of course, they didn't really explain why Dream Home Decorator was terrible. They didn't really explain why Cottage Living was boring. As far as shallow gameplay, again, I don't know it so much about the packs, at least for me personally, but about the base game overall. Now, as far as Spa Day, I admit that's not usually something that I would go play. It's not my go-to pack, but I do think that they did a nice job with the refresh for what it was. The expansion pack was good. The stuff pack was above average. The game pack was trash. It shouldn't even be called a game pack, and kits are super forgettable. This really has been a bad year for The Sims 4. So I will say, at least they're saying that the expansion pack was good and the stuff pack was above average. So if I factored into that, I wouldn't necessarily say that it would be a bad year for The Sims 4. I would just say it would be a mediocre from that review. So I do find that interesting. I guess it just depends on how you weigh certain things over. And I also do think it depends on if you're also factoring base game updates and if those are important to you. So this person basically said, "This is a terrible year for The Sims 4 because I hate kits and basically, or at least they're super forgettable, and basically the pros are not outweighing the cons for the paid DLC." Fun fact, 2021 is the most expensive in terms of content. All the other years, it was $120. In 2021, it was $125. So I did not fact check this, so you guys can let me know in the comments below if you do fact check this. Obviously, I don't advocate for more expensive years. However, I will say if it's literally a $5 difference, I guess if we get more packs, then it will be more than a $5 difference. But if it's a $5 difference, I wouldn't really mind that so much. I care more about what we're getting for that price, if that makes sense. So I would say, is the content something you're going to play with again? Are we getting base game updates with that, etc.? So you have to factor in free content as well, and it wouldn't go just based upon the price. Now again, I'm not a fan of kits personally, and I think that at very least they're coming out very rapidly right now, but I do think there probably is a reason for that, and I kind of explained that in my last video. If only the game pack wasn't so broken. The amount of bugs that came with Dream Home Decorator was crazy. I was pleasantly surprised though with the app and stuff pack plus the spa update. So now we're getting into actually more positive comments about this year. So I will say yes, I heard a lot about, I don't own it, but I heard that Dream Home Decorator has had a number of performance issues and some people playing just don't like how it plays, which of course is another issue entirely. So I did not, again, buy Dream Home Decorator. It's not really my thing, but I do know that this has been an issue with game performance, and it isn't just Dream Home Decorator. There's just been bugs out the wazoo. So I will say for 2021, especially as we get further and further, we're getting more and more bugs. And even though they started to work on bug fixes, I feel like that's kind of slowed down lately. So I'm really hoping we get more of those because, in my opinion, I don't think 2021 was by far the worst year for The Sims 4 at all. But in terms of performance, I think each year we get progressively a little bit worse, which kind of makes sense as you get more paid DLC and as you get more content. To be fair to the Sims team, not all Sims 4 content is paid for. We've also had the huge Swatch update and Spa Day refresh, and it's confirmed that there are still two base game updates to come. So this is a good point. I am really curious to see what those base game updates are. I do hope that it's something substantial with the AI or the core of the game. I have some hope for that. I think that could potentially make a big difference in the game, or at least a small difference, and potentially a bigger difference than a new pack would. But again, it really depends. It could just be new swatches, which, don't get me wrong, I am great with getting new free swatches. I think that was a great update. But of course, it's not changing the core of the game. It's changing the aesthetics of the game. There's been an entire year of gameplay and build updates to the base game and free cast and build buy. This game has some of the most consistent content releases each year. Bigger concern to me is the recent slowdown of bug fixes after the first half of the year. So I do agree with her, which is not a surprise. I feel like I'm always agreeing with her. But yeah, I think that they have been giving us free content, and I think a lot of people kind of forget about the free content they give us. And I think that stuff has been really positive. However, I will agree that I think that the bug fixes have really slowed down, and it is kind of concerning me. Like I said, from a performance standpoint, you can really love a new pack, but if you can't play it, you can't enjoy it. Don't get me wrong, I hate kits as much as the next person, which, by the way, if you're watching this and you don't hate kits, that is perfectly fine. I think we've really normalized in the Sims community that we can't have differences of opinion, and if someone likes something that we don't, that we attack them. So I am definitely against that, even though I don't think that kits are personally worth the price point. Attacking people for liking them, I think that's so silly. But I digress. I hate kids as much as the next person, but it's possible that the Sims team has run out of ideas. Like, I feel like they've hit all the big bases. What else is there to do? I think there is actually a lot they can do. Number one, with base game updates, but also with packs. I know they could do like a hotels and resorts pack. They could do a bands pack. They could do a hobbies pack. They could do a generations pack. I don't think they will, but they could. There are more cults to take care of. So I could come up with lots of ideas. They could even have a time travel pack, etc. We could go on. I can even do a brainstorming of ideas. So I personally don't think they're out of ideas. I don't think that's why they're slowing down. I think that there are many possibilities, which I talked about in my last video. I think that working remotely is one thing. And then if they really are making substantial changes to the base game, don't know if they are, but if they're doing that or refreshes, that could also slow them down as well. So obviously this is an interesting take on things from both sides. And I've said for a long time that, in fact, many Simmers actually used to say consistently, as popular to say so, that the team should slow the pack schedule down and work on bug fixes and base game alone. And I always said, there's no way they're going to do that. And that's hence the kits. So I think it's really interesting where we kind of swing one from the other. When we get what we're asking for, I shouldn't say we, a lot of the community, then they realize they don't really like it. So it's a little difficult because I think a lot of people, they think they want something and then they realize, but that means we won't get another pack. And then they get upset and say it was a bad year. So I think that's kind of mixed messaging, and it's okay to change your mind. But I think it's good to be cognizant that both things can't happen at the same time. They can't slow down the schedule and keep giving us packs, right? So that's kind of complicated. So the issue for me is that new packs are fun for a short while, and don't get me wrong, I do think they generally did a good job with Cottage Living, and I thought Paranormal Stuff Pack was actually a really good standout. But the problem is, they're fun, and they're fun for a while, so structural changes I think still need to be made. So while I personally do believe we're still going to get a surprise pack, and I explained this again in my last video, I actually have mixed emotions about that. On one hand, something like a hobbies pack or a generations pack, which, by the way, I still don't think they're going to actually do a generations pack. I've made past videos on that. But those kind of things could add some great gameplay. But if there aren't changes to the base game, will that gameplay really be lasting? Is it going to perform and run well? Or is it going to be a pendulum swing of hype and disappointment? They could do both, at least in theory, but when they're working from home, I do have some doubts about how bug fixes are going and if they're going to release a pack, if it's going to be even buggier than usual. My theory is, as the game gets older, we're going to get more bugs, but also, when they're working from home, we're going to get more bugs. So I do think, on one hand though, we do tend to get substantial updates with packs, so that also complicates things. But then again, there's bugs and performance issues, and that really starts piling up. With the amount of bugs and performance issues Sims 4 has, it's going to be really hard to enjoy a new pack. So to that end, I think it just depends on how it's done. So if they are using this time to truly invest in the base game, make some changes to the AI and performance, I actually think this could be one of the best years yet. If they're not doing that, then of course there's argument for the other side. I personally do not think that Sims 4 has had the worst year yet in 2021. I actually think there's been a lot of positive things, and of course there have been negative things, and I agree, I still don't like kits. But I'm not going to say that the existence of kits means that nothing good has happened this year, because I try to look at it holistically. But I do understand why people are upset as well. So let me know what you think in the comments below. Again, just try not to attack each other. I hope that everybody is having a wonderful day, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.